हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मोहम्मद काशिफ इकबाल फ्रॉम जामिया हमदर्द न्यू दिल्ली। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द हेयर स्टाइलिंग प्रोडक्ट्स। अंडर दिस टॉपिक वी डिस्कस डिफरेंट लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स सच एज इंट्रोडक्शन, रिक्वायर्ड क्वालिटीज एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ हेयर स्टाइलिंग प्रोडक्ट, बेसिक इन्ग्रीडियंट्स फॉर हेयर स्टाइलिंग प्रोडक्ट्स, टाइप्स ऑफ हेयर स्टाइलिंग प्रोडक्ट्स। आफ्टर दैट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट देयर फॉर्मुलेशंस, इफेक्ट ऑफ ए स्टाइलिंग प्रोडक्ट, पैकेजिंग ऑफ हेयर स्टाइलिंग प्रोडक्ट, इवेल्युएशन एंड मार्केटेड हेयर स्टाइलिंग प्रोडक्ट्स। स्टूडेंट्स, वी स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव, इंट्रोडक्शन। हेयर कैन बी स्ट्रेट, वेवी और कर्ली, ब्लंड, ब्लैक, ब्राउन, रेड, ग्रे एंड वाइट, एंड इट्स नेचुरल वेरिएशंस आर इम्पॉर्टेंट टू आवर आइडेंटिटी। हेयर स्टाइल्स कैन बी यूज टू एक्सप्रेस पर्सनैलिटी and make a social statement. In order to achieve the desired appearance, various types of styling products and or tools can be used. Manipulation of the normal structure of the hair shaft is universal and it is dictated by multiple factors including culture, religion, fashion and even celebrities. Today, sales of hair care and styling product add up to the multi-billion dollar industries. Students, now we discuss second learning objectives is required qualities and characteristic and consumer needs. From a consumer perspective, a quality hair styling product should possess the following characteristics such as easy to apply, easy to remove by shampooing, polymer based product, non flaky, non tacky even at high humidity, rapid drying time, strong hold, emollient based product, non greasy, does not make hair look oily and lump, adds in hair manageability, improves shine, good smell, provides a long lasting effect, does not damage the hair or scalp. Next, the technical qualities of hair styling, hair straightening and waving product can be summarized as the hair styling product should compatible with other ingredient in the formulation. It should be appropriate rheological properties, should have appropriate texture, should have appropriate pH, long term stability and dermatological safety. Students, now we studied about the basic ingredients for hair styling product. There are different basic ingredients used in the formulation of hair styling product such as polymers, thickeners, preservative, etc. Polymers are the main ingredient in all polymer based formulation. They are responsible for holding the hair in the style configuration and stiffening hair. The first polymer used was PVP, which is compatible with water and alcohol and has good film forming properties. The main disadvantage of PVP is that it is sensitive to humidity, becomes sticky and loses holding power when exposed to water. New polymers include PVP mixed with vinyl acetate, which makes it more resistant to water. It is a valuable characteristic from a styling perspective as it offers a stronger holding power. However, it can make hair more difficult to clean. Additional examples for polymers used today include other copolymers, that is polymer made by reacting two different monomers such as vinyl pyrrolidone, dimethyl aminoethyl methyl acrylate copolymer, octyl acrylamide acrylates, butyl aminoethyl methyl acrylates polymer, etc. Students, second important ingredient used in the hair styling product is anhydrous base. The anhydrous base provides a waxy, oily mass for the formulation. Ingredients of the anhydrous base provide a hair conditioning effect and prevent damage. For example, beeswax, petrolatum, lanolin, vegetable oils, mineral oils, and silicones. Next, thickener is also an important ingredient in the manufacturing of hair styling product. Thickeners provide viscosity control to the formulation. They are most commonly hydrophilic ingredient applied primarily in gels. There are different examples of thickeners such as polyacrylates like carbomer, cellulose derivative such as hydroxyethyl cellulose and polysaccharides. Next, propellants. Propellants are essential ingredient in aerosol formulation such as aerosol hair spray and aerosol mozzies. They help expel the content of the aerosol can. For example, dimethyl ether, propane, butane and fluorinated hydrocarbons. Plasticizers is also play an important role in the preparation of hair styling product. Plasticizer make polymer films more flexible. There are different types of plasticizers used in the preparation such as dimethicone, castor oil and different mineral oils. Next, sunscreen. Sunscreens are often employed in hair styling product. They provide protection against UV radiation. And sunscreen helps maintain the attractive appearance of the hair. There are different types of sunscreen used such as benzophenone 4 and octyl methoxycinnamate. Next, chelating agent. Chelating agent provide protection against metal ions, improves the stability of gels and increase the efficiency of preservative system. EDTA and its derivatives are generally used as a chelating agent. Next, preservative. Preservatives provide protection against microbial contamination in water-based system. Parabens and phenoxyethanols are generally used as a preservative in the formulation of hair styling product. There are different additional ingredients are also used in the formulations such as humectant that contribute to the wet look provided by gels, conditioners such as proteins and quaterniums, fragrances, vitamins and herbal extracts. Students, now we discuss types and definition of hair styling product. First, polymer based hair styling products. Polymer based product helps improve the hair volume and height by increasing the hair strand stiffness and hair fiber interactions. They coat hair fibers with a thin film layer and form links between the fibers. Hair spray, styling gel, mousses, styling gum and liquid setting products work based on this principle. First, hair sprays. Hair sprays are available in two major forms, aerosol product and non-aerosol product. Both types are usually applied to dry hair as a final step of styling the hair. Aerosol hair sprays are one of the most widely used hair styling products by both consumer and hair stylist. Aerosol hair sprays are released from the container with the help of a propellant which result in very fine particles such as a mist. Due to the small particle size of the droplet, they dry quickly. Non-aerosol hair sprays are dispersed from a plastic container supplied with a pump head. The distribution of the hair spray is provided mechanically by the pump head, which forms bigger droplets and therefore can wet the hair more rapidly. Hair sprays, especially those formulated to provide a strong hold, tend to form flakes on the hair. Next, setting lotion or hair setting lotions. Setting lotion known as wave set and applied from a small bottle with a nozzle to towel dried hair. Rolled onto curling rollers, setting lotions coat the hair fibers and set them in curled shape. Next, hair mousses. Hair mousses are available in aerosol and non-aerosol forms. However, the aerosol types are far more popular. Both types are typically applied to the towel dried hair followed by drying and styling. They can also be applied to dry hair to create a wet, spiky look. Next, hair styling fiber gums. Hair styling fiber gums known as putties are relatively new product designed to add increased hold to the hair. They are usually gum-like opaque emulsion. Fiber gums are more popular among younger customers with shorter hair. These products are bendable and moldable styling products that can be used to create various hair styles including spikes or smoother look. Next, hair gels. Hair gels are also very popular hair styling product. They can offer both a smooth hold and an extreme look with a spike depending on whether the product is applied to wet or dry hair and whether the hair is blow dried or air dried. Next type of hair styling product is emollient based hair styling formulation. Emollient based product can help smooth out frizz and increase hair shine by aligning fibers and reducing friction, and can also have a conditioning effect on hair fibers. They work on the principle of depositing waxes and emollients on hair fibers. They are often used for thicker, curly or kinky hair which is hard to handle and can be very dry. Hair cream, wax, pomade, brillantes and oil spray work based on this principle. Next, hair pomades. Hair pomades is the emollient based type of hair styling formulation. Hair pomades are also known as cream brillantes, are anhydrous products based on petrol atom and various waxes. As the product are quite thick, they are usually warmed up in the palm before being applied to the hair. Next, hair brillantines are liquid based on oil and silicones. These products are designed to allow for easy styling and add shine to the hair without providing a greasy appearance. Next, sprayable oils and silicones. These products are also known as oil sheen sprays. These are usually aerosolized oil that may also contain additional conditioning agents such as proteins. Next, hair creams. Hair creams are emulsion product providing modest hold and high gloss. They may also be oil in water or water in oil emulsion, which break down easily on application. Students, now we studied about the formulation of hair styling products. First, formulation of polymer based hair styling product. The formulation of low viscosity product is relatively simple. Generally, ingredients are blended with agitation and mixed until homogeneous. During the formulation of a product containing thickening ingredient, dispersion of the thickeners is a critical step. Thickeners are hygroscopic and tend to form clumps if added too fast to the dispersing medium or if no or slow agitation is used. Certain thickeners need pH adjustment, means neutralization, to reach their optimal viscosity. In such cases, the neutralizer should be added after proper hydration of the thickener in order to avoid clumping. Students, now we studied about a general formula and formulation for tack-free sprayable lotions. These tack-free sprayable lotions contain different ingredients such as alcohol of different grade, water, amino methyl propanol, butyl esters, cyclomethicones, dimethicones and fragrances. Students, apart from the tack-free sprayable lotions, we have also different formulations such as hair setting lotions. The content of hair setting lotions is discussed in the table. There are different ingredients such as water, PVP, glycerin, cetrimonium chloride, oleth, diazolidone, urea, butyl carbamate, etc. Next, we have formulation of heat waving lotions. The heat waving lotions contain monoethanol amine, potassium sulfite, potassium carbonate, ammonium carbonate, borax, sulfonated castor oil, water, etc. Now we discuss about a general formula and formulation for styling gel with UV screen. This formulation contain water, oleth, PVP, water, etc. The formulation of the styling gel in the different steps. First, pre-melt and mix the dimethyl pavamidopropyl lauridemonium tosylate and propylene glycol stearate and add to the oleate 20 at 60 degrees Celsius. Mix until clear and homogeneous solution obtained. Add to 55 degrees Celsius water and mix until clear formulation obtained. Cool to 25 to 40 degrees Celsius. Add other constituent in order and deaerate before adding the pre-diluted acrylate thickeners. Mix at least 30 minutes after clarity is achieved. Students, now we discuss about the general formula and formulation of cream gel. These formulation contain water, carbomer, glycerate, DMDMH, diisopropyl adipate, isocetyl stearate, dimethicone, fragrance, etc. The formulation is performed in different steps. First, prepare carbomer in water in main kettle. Add other components, esters and silicone will float on top. Dilute PVP VA in water and add neutralizer and additives. Transfer PVP VA phase to the main kettle and mix until gel is complete. A neutralization begins the oil and pulled into the gel. Mixing will create a uniform mechanical dispersion of droplets of oil which makes the gel opaque and can be measured under the microscope to confirm uniformity throughout the batch. Students, now we discuss about the general formula and formulation of Nuuly hair straighteners. And this formulation is prepared into the two part, part A and part B. And these parts contain different ingredients. Part A contain Polowax, cetyl alcohol, sterile alcohol, PEG-75 lanolin, petrol atom, mineral oil, lanethanol 15, PEG-24, PEG-25. Part B contain water, polysorbate, oleate, calcium hydroxide, polycutaneum, propylene glycol, lithium carbonate, psyllium and titanium dioxide. Formulation is performed into the different steps. First, part A is emulsified into part B at elevated temperature to create component 1. Component 2nd is prepared by adding propylene glycol to the kettle and begins with moderate agitation with a high speed Cowell's disperse blade. Add lithium carbonate slowly. Continue disperser action and add silica and titanium dioxide. Continue mixing for 30 minutes. Students, now we discuss about the effect of styling products. Styling aids not only assist in increasing volume and shine, but are also useful in improving the appearance of hair. Dermatologic conditions that result in thinning hair, hair damage or hair loss. People can damage and lose hair for various reasons including illness, certain medications and genetics. Even harsh chemical treatments can also lead to severe damage or loss. In addition, thinning of hair can severely affect people's self-confidence and impact their quality of life and in many cases lead to significant psychological and emotional distress. Hair styling aids such as hair spray and gels can be used to lift thinning hair and create the illusion of fullness. Oil and silicone spray can help restore shine and improve the appearance of very dry or even splitting hair. Hair styling aids are in general safe for the skin and hair and can have many benefits. Consumers, however, often use more styling product than what they actually need or they do not use to proper type of styling aid. Temporary and permanent hair waving and straightening are commonly used hair styling techniques which are considered safe only if used carefully, selected according to the consumer hair type and following the manufacturer's directions. Students, now we studied about the major negative effects of product and tools on the hair and scalp. Overuse of hair styling product based on film forming polymers can create a whited down effect, reduction in lusters, or even appearance of white flakes. Overuse of emollient-based hair styling product can create a greasy lump appearance, the opposite of what user are trying to achieve. Irritation and allergic reaction to hair styling product are rare, but fragrances and certain preservative added to this formulation may cause irritation reaction in sensitive skin patient. Heat can be efficiently used to temporarily reshape the hair into a desired form. However, very high temperature may lead to significant irreversible damage of hair fibers. Improper steps in permanent straightening can lead to significant hair damage, loss of hydrophobicity, increased porosity, split end, hair breakage, rough, dry, dull, and brittle hair, and even loss of the cuticle. Students, now we talk about the evaluation of hair styling products. Quality parameters commonly tested by cosmetic companies to evaluate the quality of their hair styling product as stiffness of hair fibers. In stiffness of hair fibers, hair fixatives can significantly change the stiffness, flexibility of hair fibers, which can be measured with a tensile meter. Stiffness is usually determined by the bending test, most commonly the three-point bending test. In this test, a hair trace is dipped into a hair spray solution or a diluted gel and is allowed to dry in flat position. After drying, the bending stiffness is measured by fixing the hair trace horizontally on two arms and moving the central arms of the equipment vertically, applying the bending force to the hair trace. In the test, force required to bend or break the polymer film is recorded. Usually, stiffness is proportional to the viscosity of polymer solution and the total amount of polymer deposit on the hair. Next evaluation is fixative tackiness. A slight amount of tackiness is usually expected by the users as a sign of proper working of the product. Too much tackiness will, however, cause the hair to stick to the brush hand to a point of making difficult to style. In the tackiness test, hair traces are treated with a hair spray or other hair fixative and are evaluated by panelist. The time needed to indicate the absence of tack on hair is usually measured, which also refers to the drying time of the polymer film. Next, dynamic hair spray analysis. This technique generally employs a commercial instrument, the texture analyzer. In the test, the hair traces are shaped into a omega loop while the two sides of hair traces are glued onto the surface. A probe moves down to touch the hair trace and deforms it to a predefined extent and moves back. This movement is repeated and predetermined number of times. Initially, the untreated hair is evaluated, which is then sprayed with the test product and the hair trace deformed again. The equipment measures stiffness and increases the stiffness after applying the hair spray as well as tackiness and drying time. Various temperature and humidity values can also be employed in the measurement to see how these would modify the performance of the formulation. Next test is the curl retention for long-lasting styling hold. The polymer-based hair fixative may claim long-term curl retention, which has to be substantiated. The test generally used is called the curl snap test. In this test, the hair fixative is applied to the hair traces, which are then wrapped onto curlers and allowed to dry. After drying, the hair traces are carefully removed from the curler and hang up to the support board. The initial length of the curls is recorded and then a wide toothed comb is passed through the traces. The length, lowermost portion of the traces is recorded, which can be used to calculate the curl retention of the hair fixative. Curl retention is calculated as percentage curl retention equal to length of uncurled hair traces minus length of the hair at the time of reading upon length of uncurled hair trace minus length of the curl at the start of the experiment into 100. Next evaluation is humidity resistance of the treated hair traces. A number of hair fixative formulation claim high holding power even in humid environment. The test usually used is similar to the curl retention test. First, a hair fixative is applied to the hair traces, which are then wrapped onto curlers and allowed to dry. After drying, the hair traces are carefully removed from the curler and hang up to a support board. The initial length of the curls is recorded and then they are placed into the high humidity environment. The length is recorded as predefined time interval and then the curl retention is calculated based on the original length and final length as a percentage. Next, flaking. Overuse of polymer based hair fixative can lead to flaking. The test flaking usually panelists are involved. The fixative is applied to the hair traces and allowed to dry. The hair traces are hang up onto a supporting board and a small toothed comb is then passed through the hair traces. The hair comb and are under the support stand a inspected and graded by the panelist to evaluate flaking. Next, the DIT value. The DIT value is measured of the tighten of the curls. Higher the DIT value, the better the performance of priming solution and the tighter the curl. It is usually calculated using the following formula: DIT equal to diameter of the curl in mm minus diameter of the rod in mm upon diameter of the rod in mm into the 100. Next, curl length. Curl length is measured of the spring of the curl. Optimally, curl should be springly after being removed from the curling rod. The curl length is usually evaluated by fixing a fresh curl and observing its springs. The degree of laxity is proportional to the degree of the hair shaft damage. Thus, longer curls are indicative of greater hair shaft damage. Next, 20% index. The 20% index is used to evaluate the strength of the permanently waved hair. This parameter is determined by stretching the freshly permed hair with the uniformly increasing load. The 20% index refers to the ratio of the load required to stretch a standardized wet hair stress to 20% of its original length after and before perming. The higher the index, the lower the reduction in the hair strength. Hair with a low 20% index will tend to break easily upon applying minimal trauma such as combing. Students, now we studied about the packaging of hair styling products. The most commonly used packaging materials for hair styling products include plastic bottles, plastic and metal jars. Plastic bottles, many hair fixative and supplied in plastic bottles, usually with a flip-flop cap or a pump head. Plastic and metal jars. Hair styling formulations such as gel, creams and waxes may also be supplied in plastic and metal jars. Next, soft tubes. Gels and creams can also be filled into soft-sided tubes with a screw cap or a flip-flop cap. Next, aerosol cans. Aerosol hair sprays and hair mousses are supplied in one compartment cans where the formulation and the propellant are mixed together. Aerosol containers can be made of thin coated steel, tin free steel or aluminium. The material of the can is an important factor to be taken into consideration as the product with the certain pH or certain solvent may have an interaction with the can. Valve type is also an important factor to be considered. Valve selection should address sprayability, clogging and evacuation. Students, now we discuss about the different marketed hair styling products brand like Tresemme, Tiggy Bed Head, L'Oreal Paris, Himalaya and Sunsilk, etc. Students, now we conclude our topic as hair are straight, wavy or curly, blunt, black, brown, red, grey and white, and its natural variation are important to our identity. Today, sales of hair care and styling product add up to a multi-billion dollar industry. Hair styling products should have following characteristics such as easy to apply, easy to remove by shampooing. Polymer based product provide a long lasting effect and does not damage the hair or scalp, etc. The technical qualities of hair styling, hair straightener and waving product can be summarized as compatible with the other ingredient in the formulation, appropriate rheological properties, appropriate texture, appropriate pH, long-term stability and dermatological safety. Basic ingredients for hair styling products are polymers, anhydrous waxes, thickeners, propellant, plasticizers, sunscreen, etc. There are different types of hair styling products available, such as polymer based hair styling products like hair sprays, setting lotion, hair mousses, hair styling fiber gums, hair gels, and emollient based hair styling formulations such as hair creams, etc. Styling aids not only assist in increasing the volume and shine but also useful in improving the appearance of hair, dermatologic conditions that result in thinning hair, hair damage or hair loss. Overuse of hair styling product based on film forming polymer can create a whited down effect, reduction in luster or even appearance of white flecks. Overuse of emollient based hair styling product can create a greasy lump appearance, the opposite of what users are trying to achieve. Most commonly used packaging materials for hair styling products are glass jar, plastic bottles and aerosol cans. In order to maintain uniform standards for hair styling product, the following evaluation tests are conducted, such as stiffness of hair fibers, fixative tackiness, dynamic hair spray analysis, curl retention for long lasting hair styling hold, humidity resistance of treated hair tresses, flaking, the DIT value, curl length and 20% indexes. Thank you.